Ja, liebe Frau Tietmeyer, sehr geehrte Familie Tietmeyer,
dear Tietmeyer family. Herr
Minister Schäuble, liebe
Minister
Frau Schäuble,
dear Herr Jean-Claude, Mr. Schäuble, cher Jean-Claude,
sehr geehrter Herr Bundespräsident
Köhler,
lieber Mario, caro Mario,
dear Mario,
sehr geehrte Gäste,
dear guests,
ich begrüße Sie
I
alle
like to
ganz
you
herzlich
very
zu diesem
Kolloquium,
zu Ehren von
in honor
Tietmeyer,
of Hans Tietmeyer,
dem ehemaligen Bundesbankpräsidenten, den wir alle gemeinsam
and
sehr
we
viel
all
verdanken.
Know that we owe him
sehr verehrte Frau Tietmeyer,
Mrs. Tietmeyer,
der für Sie und Ihre Familie so schmerzliche Tod ihres
Almost
Mannes.
Almost 6 months have passed since the passing away of your husband.
A
painful event for you and your family. And you asked us to wait a little before meeting at his former place of work, before meeting here for this colloquium in his remembrance and also to honor his life's achievement for our country and for Europe. I'm very happy to see that so many of his companions are here today and that you, dear Mr. Schäuble, will address us later and also you, Jean-Claude.
Hans Tietmeyer,
Hans Tietmeyer was born on the 18th of August 1931 in the Westphalian
Dorf
village Mettelen, close to the Dutch border.
Sein Vater, ein
His father
Beamter in der
was a civil servant in the municipal administration, and he had to feed
Kindern
a family with 11 children.
So
you can easily imagine that the Tietmeyer home was a rather modest one, and early on everybody had to help to contribute to the family's livelihood. In order to finance his studies, Hans Tietmeyer had to work a lot and work very hard. And he did not consider himself too good for anything. He cleaned textile machines. He worked as a forest worker. And at times he also worked underground in a coal mine.
Sein Berufswunsch
Early on,
stand jedoch
he really knew what he wanted to become. He wanted to become a priest.
Deswegen schrieb sich zunächst That's ein für
he started by enrolling for Catholic theology and philosophy. So one of his professors in Münster at the time was Joseph Höfner, who was later to become Cardinal of Cologne. Now he actually taught Catholic social teaching and without wanting to, I think, he was a major factor in Tietmeyer's life. And young Tietmeyer, after only 3 semesters, changed his field of study. Hans Tietmeyer himself said at one point, Höfner actually got me to be interested in economics. I wanted to change the world. And very quickly I saw that first of all I had to learn how the world that I wanted to change is structured and set up and how it works. So it was only logical really to study economics. He moved from the Münster University to the Cologne University in order to take a course of studies in economics. And again, he came across an academic teacher who had a decisive influence on his career, Alfred Müller-Armack, who stated the guiding principles of the social market economy. After graduating, Hans Tietmeyer found a way to combine his Christian conviction with his economic studies. First of all, he became a managing director of the Episcopal Academic Foundation Cusanuswerk and at the same time earned his PhD with a thesis on the social situation of students and assistance available from the state. It was logical for him, because after all, he was a representative of the students who was involved in the negotiations of the so-called Hanef model, the predecessor of today's federal law on support in education. Like moving from theology to economy and economics, the next step in his career gave him a new direction too. The economist Tietmeyer, with his firm convictions on the basic principles of economic governance, it led him into the sphere of economic policies, and he stayed loyal to this for the remainder of his life. He started out in the Federal Ministry of Economics, where he came across figures who really had a decisive influence on the economic policy of the Federal Republic, Ludwig Erhard, Karl Schiller and Otto Graf Lambsdorff.
Von Lambsdorff bekam Hans Dietmayer auch den Auftrag,
it was Lambsdorff who asked Dietmayer to write a memorandum on a new orientation of German economic policies from a market economy perspective. And today we know that the so-called Lambsdorff paper was a major factor in the breaking apart of the social liberal coalition in 1982. It was then the Ministry of Finance headed by Gerhard Stoltenberg where Hans Dietmayer became Secretary of State and Undersecretary of State in charge of monetary policy and international financial relations. Part of his job was to prepare the federal chancellor as a Sherpa for the World Economic Summit, and I know from my own experience that this requires diplomatic skills, steadfastness and sometimes also a bit of flexibility. Hans Dietmayer liked to compare himself to a Westphalian oak, something that stands for steadfastness, strength and persistence.
Eigenschaften,
definitely property and characteristics that were typical of Hans Dietmayer. Referring to the oak really is like a metaphor. The journalist Werner Bankhoff put it in a more drastic way at one particular point in time. He called Dietmayer a pig-headed Westphalian. This steadfastness, however, is something that many have paid tribute to. The former president of the American Fed, Paul Volcker, who unfortunately cannot be here today, wrote just a few days to me. He wrote a personal letter to me stating the following. Hans had strong views. The importance of price stability, of a strong and independent central bank, and of a united and vigorous European Union.
We all
looked to him as a tower of strength, reinforcing our own commitment to stability.
Hans Dietmayer,
however, was not just steadfast. He was also a passionate and very successful table tennis player. And when you play table tennis, it's very important to show quick responses. And that's definitely something that he did show. Later, Heribert Klein in the FAZ magazine wrote, the ability to skillfully deliver a ball back is something Dietmayer still knows how to do. Apparently, this quick-wittedness and the quick responses that he learned with table tennis was also something that he used for his linguistic and verbal reactions. These two characteristics are hardly ever found together, responding quickly and being quick-witted, but this is something that Hans Dietmayer proved again when he was actually called to become a member of the executive board of Deutsche Bundesbank. On top of his experience in monetary policy, he had just arrived when Helmut Kohl asked him to serve as a personal advisor to the federal chancellor to negotiate East-West German monetary union. This is what happens in life. So, when you're an outstanding personality, you're needed in different places. And Mr. Schäuble is certainly going to mention and explain the very important role of Hans Dietmayer in German history. Back at Bundesbank, Hans Dietmayer in 1991 succeeded Helmut Schlesinger as Vice President of Bundesbank. And in 1993, he then became its president. Dietmayer's years with Bundesbank were dominated by the preparations for the European Economic and Monetary Union, paving the way for the introduction of the Euro.
Europe
had already proved to be a common theme of the professional career of Hans Dietmayer. Monetary integration of Europe, he was there right from the very beginning. It was already at the beginning of the 70s that Hans Dietmayer was part of the so-called Werner Group. They had presented a plan which, as far as the substance was concerned, was very close to the later Maastricht Treaty, although it couldn't be carried through. It was to take another two decades until the Treaty of Maastricht actually laid the foundation for a European Economic and Currency Union, and then some additional 7 years, mainly coinciding with the presidency of Hans Dietmayer, some additional 7 years were needed to prepare for the third stage of the monetary union before the common currency was then introduced. 30 years then after the Werner paper, the European population had the euro in their hands. 30 years of economic history decisively influenced by Hans Tietmeyer. The Treaty of Maastricht established pricing stability and price stability as the priority goal of monetary policy, and monetary government financing by the central banks was forbidden. What was just as important, however, for the monetary union as a stability union, what is just as important was the independence of the central banks. Experience from the 70s and the early 80s showed that independent central banks were much more successful in guaranteeing price stability than dependent ones. In view of the new European Central Bank, David Marsh, a former correspondent of the Financial Times and an intimate and critical expert of Bundesbank matters, so he in his usual pointed manner said, the EU had actually approved of the new institution was to be a copy of Bundesbank. As president of the Bundesbank, Hans Tietmeyer did not just focus on maintaining the monetary union as a stability union. He was vehemently in favor of the Stability and Growth Pact, and he also considered the convergence reports to be an important lever to provide stability to the monetary union. Only those member states of the EU were to be part and allowed to be part of the monetary union that had sufficient degree of economic convergence. He kept emphasizing how important it was for the convergence criteria not to be violated and that there must be no compromises. At the 75th birthday of Hans Tietmeyer, the economist Jürgen P. Donges from Cologne reminded everybody that Tietmeyer angered many people because he took the Maastricht Treaty seriously. Hans Tietmeyer knew what dramatic changes a monetary union actually brought and meant for the member states. In a very far-sighted speech in Paris in October 1997, he said the following about the common currency, I quote, it creates a strong and faithful link because the members then share the responsibility for the stability of the currency, not just through common monetary policy, but also through their national financial policy in the broader sense of the term. And because of this link for the joint currency, there's going to be even more external pressure in view of internal flexibility, reforms and discipline. He therefore warned against weakening of the efforts after the introduction of the common currency. Europe must not just shelve the topic of convergence after the monetary union is started. And he also predicted the monetary union will not just see sunny days, there's also going to be rain and storms. How true these words are or were is something that we see very well today. The willingness to reform demanded by Tietmeyer has not always been there at every point in time. There were quite a few countries that needed the financial and sovereign debt crisis in order to start adjusting in a more comprehensive manner. Therefore, it gives reason to worry that the enthusiasm for reforms has waned with the crisis subsiding, but it is a good signal that the new French president actually focuses again on the political agenda. Hans Tietmeyer would have liked that because the German-French balance was also close to his heart. Another reason was, however, that the capital markets took the concept of a community of fate to mean that in spite of all the bans and prohibitions of Maastricht, countries would help out each other if it came to a crunch. So it was a rather frivolous approach with which the euro countries received loans and credits at the same conditions, although some of them had very different economic backgrounds and criteria. Hans Tietmeyer kept pointing out that the joint currency really demands a lot of the member states. It was in 1996 when he said, monetary policy alone cannot achieve and secure stability of price levels. There are other areas of economic policy where everybody involved has to act in line with stability requirements. And fiscal and wage policies have particular responsibility here. On top of the monetary union, Hans Tietmeyer actually also wished for a deeper political integration. He knew, however, always that the individual member states had major responsibility for the stability of the economic or currency region, as long as fiscal and economic policy sovereignty was at the national levels. So it is gratifying and very much in the accordance with the wishes of Hans Tietmeyer that the report on the future of the economic and monetary union refuses to accept a communitization of debt and points out to the necessary balance of liability and action.
So, competences
also have to be transferred to the community level and stability-oriented decisions are guaranteed.
Entgegen dem Satz von Jean Monnet,
contrary to the sentence
in Krisen
of Jean Monnet,
stand für Hans Tietmeyer
according to which
fest,
Europe is forged together in crisis, Hans Tietmeyer stated it differently. He said, I quote, a progressing integration is not to be the child of crises, not allowing for any other way out. It should be a planned child, based on the wish for more communality. Hans Tietmeyer was never at odds with the loss of monetary autonomy, and he always focused on stability political interests of Europe. Together with Ottmar Issing, the first chief economist of ECB, he introduced the stability-oriented position of Bundesbank into the ECB Council.
Als Vertreter des
and he considered himself not a representative of Germany, but all of the euro area. In his farewell speech as federal as Bundesbank president in August 1999, he said, in the new Eurogroup, Bundesbank is to be a reliable, knowledgeable and committed proponent of permanently stable money. There's no doubt that Bundesbank has been living up to this claim and expectation of Tietmeyer. However, he did understand that stability is not indispensable just because of the value of the money, but that it is also a major stability in view of the international financial systems. Monetary stability in an instable system can hardly be reached. The financial crisis of the 90s have really underlined the importance of financial stability. Although the effects compared to the global financial crisis of 2007 were limited, in an almost visionary manner, Tietmeyer pushed ahead with the establishment of the Financial Stability Forum in 1999. Later, as part of the global financial crisis, G20 actually broadened this body, gave it a broader mandate and turned it into Financial Stability Board. Today it is the hub of the international discussions on financial stability and the efforts to make the international financial system more robust through common rules. Without this body, which was established by Hans Tietmeyer, the remarkable progress of the international community in the past years wouldn't have been possible. The foundation of the work of Hans Tietmeyer for Europe and for the stability, the very foundation was his pro-market economy conviction, which was deeply rooted by his early teachers, Müller, Armack and Ludwig Erhard. He was always in favor of more competition, less patronization by the state, and more responsibility and self-initiative for the individual and of the individual. Part of this orientation on competition, however, for him was also to fight for a stable monetary situation. Inflation impairs the controlling and information function of prices because changes of the relative prices cannot be distinguished from changes of the general pricing level. Inflation, therefore, destroys the very foundation of the market economy. Therefore, for Walter Eucken, price stability was a constituent feature of any market economy. His conviction of the basic regulatory task of politics actually helped him to guide the curatorium, the advisory board of the initiative Neue Soziale Marktwirtschaft, when he had left the office of President of Bundesbank. Federal President Köhler describes the work of Hans Tietmeyer as follows. That's what he said at his 75th birthday. The name, and he meant Hans Tietmeyer, stands for the principal defense of the basic values of the market, social market economy and the transfer of the successful model of Deutsche Bundesbank to the economic and monetary union of Europe. A few months before he left the office of President of Bundesbank, not too far away, some fellow citizens of Mettelen planted a Westphalian oak. At its foot, there is a bronze plaque with the following inscription.
Dem Herrn Bundesbankpräsidenten Professor Dr. Dr.
President of Bundesbank, Professor Dr. Dr. Hans Tietmeyer, honorary citizen of Mettelen, and then in the Westphalian Low German.
Sehr wie die Danke. Also für die, die kein Platz
in low German, those who don't understand this low German dialect, we'd like to thank you with this
Hans
oak from
Mettelen. Hans Tietmeyer,
who actually helped planting this oak, quoted the French economist Léon Walras, who at one point said, if you want to harvest on short notice, you plant carrots and lettuce. When you're ambitious, you plant oaks.
Und dann kann man sagen,
and then you can say, my descendants
ihren Schatten verdanken.
Will actually owe the shade to me.
Bei zwei Jahrzehnten
after almost two decades, the little tree planted then already provides quite a bit of shade, and
wachsen.
The oak will keep growing.
Nicht wenige werden dankbar
and
sein
not many will be, not,
few,
not a few will be grateful for the growing shade, and they will remember Hans Tietmeyer, the president
who made sure
that the European Monetary Union was shaped in the light of the tradition of stability of Deutsche Bundesbank. Thank you very much for your attention.